started thinking about Spotlight Romania, about organizing it, because we are Romanians living in The Hague, and we really like being here, but we're also still very much connected to the film and photography scene back in Romania. And there are several amazing things happening there, and we thought that these amazing and inspiring things should be shared here. Because in the Netherlands, there's this eagerness and openness when it comes to exploring new cultural territories. And on the other hand, Romania is fairly underrepresented when it comes to cultural events. So we thought we will try to open a door to this creative, contemporary Romania, the vibrant Romania that we know. When it comes to films, to Romanian films, things are fairly easy to sell, to put things in context. For reasons that seem to have a great deal to do with the fact that Romania is an ex-communist country, in the early 2000s, there was a new generation of filmmakers, filmmakers that made very fresh films with a very particular cinematic style and with very strong, powerful stories and narratives. They became known as the New Romanian Wave. Their films got picked up by festivals, by the great festivals such as Cannes and Berlinale, and that really matters because festival selections and awards, of course, and the film reviews, the critics' reviews, can determine whether or not a film gets to be distributed in cinemas such as this one for audiences and moviegoers that are interested in more alternative, independent cinema. And so the Romanian New Wave got all this, and they also created a huge capital for the younger filmmakers that came behind them, behind filmmakers such as Corneliu Corumboiu, Cristian Mungiu, Radu Muntean, and Cristi Puiu, to name a few. In fact, Radu Jude, the director of tonight's film, is from this second generation, sort of the wave after the wave. He was an apprentice and long-term collaborator of Radu Muntean. He worked as his first assistant director on several projects, both in film and in advertising. He directed a series of very strong short films that became festival darlings. He already debuted in a feature film. He has two feature films before Aferim. But Aferim came as a big surprise within his own body of work, but also as a surprise in the larger Romanian cinema context landscape. Because although his film is like the new wave in a way, exploring social realism themes. In this case, the social realism of a 19th century Wallachia, a fairly retrograde territory that would become later part of modern Romania. And although the film has a lot of humor, like the other films in the new wave, this one is not a minimalistic film, as the new wave has been mostly recognized for. It is, as you might already know because you're here, it is a road movie, a black and white film, the story of a father and son, policemen at that time, who are commissioned to retrieve a fugitive, a gypsy slave, to his master. The film won the Silver Bear in Berlinale this year. Remarkably, this is the third bear won by a Romanian feature film in the last 4 years, so that's actually quite a big thing.
Care-i fiule?
Nu
știm
nimic,
bre! Care-mi zici, dau un
somn. Nu știm. Mama, nu ne-a zis nimica. Cu plăcere, ca pe care o stare și face că lucrurile ne doar. Mereu, dar nu știu.
Ce zici, mă?
Că nu știu încă, că nu
s-a dus în pădure la urat. De unde știi?
Mi-a zis că ne-am întâlnit la semana, că vrea să fugă la urat, că e mai bine acolo, e slobozând, e mai mult.
Bine.
Nu am văzut cu coane.
Hai să o coane, dar ce-i celor rău, dar acolo, când îmi găsesc în așa, că am văzut cu Ioriță!